Baju layang. Apaan tuh, Pak?
Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. This is our last meeting, and I hope that even we have a short meeting, we can learn together.
So today's topic is English as Morpheus and Tech. First, I'm going to make a review. So
this unit will pay more attention to the diagram. Should I use this? To the previous lecturer use this?
No,
she doesn't use it. So this unit will pay more attention to the diagram on clauses. Since subordination will be dealing with clauses, a complex sentence consists of main and one or more subordinate clauses. That's why we see that it is possible to have more than one S note in a sentence. The example we looked at earlier, the man who is walking in the garden likes apple, was said to consist of main clause. The man likes apple is the main clause, and subordinate clauses is who is walking in the garden. So today's topic, we are focused on subordinate.
What is subordinate? Do you have your book?
Yes.
Do you prefer me to speak in English or switch my languages? Okay, so you can find it on ebook. Today's topic on page 9.34, the title is subordination. Have you found it?
Yes.
Okay, good. So today's topic, we are focused on this section. Since all the online material we have reviewed,
9.34.
Yeah, 9.34. Yeah, you need to change everything. So first, before I start for this subordination, I will make a review from the very beginning classes. First, phrase structure rules. As a student in linguistics, you have to familiar with this name, Noam Chomsky. Chomsky is a big name in our field. Jadi Chomsky ini nama besar di field kita. Karena kita fieldnya adalah sastra, jadi harus tahu siapa itu Noam Chomsky. Noam Chomsky adalah seseorang, he is proposing this word, phrase structure rules. So in the online learning, when we learn about trees, how make a sentence, how to divide some sentence into trees, the one who proposed it is Noam Chomsky. So phrase structure rules are a type of rewrite rule used to describe a given language's syntax and are closely associated with the early stages of transformational grammar. So in structure rules, we will familiar with the word constituent. What is constituent? Constituent is a word or group of words that function as a unit and can make up a larger grammatical unit. So rules that determine what goes into phrase is constituent. And this is the abbreviation. Ini singkatannya. S stand for sentence. Non and P stand for non phrase. You can have a look on page 8.2. Do you still remember if you 8.2? There are five rules. 8.2. There are five rules that we need to memorize. Actually, we have to memorize. But if you don't memorize it, just open the book. It's okay for me. That for determiner. Do you still remember what is determiner? Are you missing it? Determiner?
The.
Then?
The.
That, okay. A. An. That's determiner.
And
N for noun and V for verb. So that's the abbreviation. So before we go further, you have to familiar with this and these are the rules. For example,
sentence consists of noun phrase and verb phrase. Can you see this?
Yes.
Okay. Noun phrase. Ada misalkan contoh, can you give me example?
Noun phrase, right?
Apa itu noun?
Noun is kata benda.
Okay, kata benda. Berarti noun itu apa aja contohnya?
Buku.
Book.
Pen.
Apple.
Teacher. Can a teacher? Is a teacher noun?
Yes, teacher.
Is teacher noun?
Is teacher noun?
Apakah teacher noun?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so noun phrase. Karena ini noun phrase, contohnya adalah misalnya. The talking teacher. Or an apple. Ini adalah noun phrase. Kemudian verb phrase. Mau bisa kasih contoh verb phrase?
Will give.
Okay, will give. In English, when we make a verb phrase, it must consist at least two verb, it becomes verb phrase. Nah, selanjutnya,
verb, it also can consist as auxiliary and verb. Do you still remember auxiliary? Auxiliary is has, have. For example, I have eaten that food. I have watched that movie. That's auxiliary and verb. And this is the general rule of phrase structure rules. The general schema is X, Y, Z. X consists of Y followed by Z. Y followed by Z. For example of the phrase structure rules, John is a noun. The boy is the determiner. Boy is a noun. A little boy is a is determiner. Little is adjective. Boy is a noun. A boy in a bubble. A boy. A is determiner. Boy is noun. In a bubble is prepositional phrase. Why we call it prepositional phrase? Do you still remember preposition? In, at, of, above, that's preposition. So prepositional phrase is in a bubble. And please remember the word in the bracket. This is indicate optional. So it's not necessary to exist. This one is the phrase structure trees. I guess maybe some of you still confused when I talk this online. Yes. Or maybe some of you didn't listen that, so you don't, because you didn't have time, so you didn't have time to review this. Right now I will review that together. Actually, it's difficult too for me, that's why I always study before I come here. So phrase structural trees, noun phrase. Please open 8.3. So basically it's like a math. Masih ingat pelajaran matematika ketika membuat pohon faktor. Nah, sentence on the first rule, it consists of noun phrase, auxiliary and verb phrase. And noun phrase itself for the second rule consists of determiner and noun. And auxiliary itself for phrase consists of this one.
Determiner.
Verb. It can be noun phrase. It can be
pohon faktor ini bisa semakin besar tergantung kalau kita sudah masukkan konstituen. Tadi masih ingat kan, konstituen itu kan unit terkecil. The smallest unit is this one. A, bubble, in, boy, a, boy, little, a, boy, the, and John. That's the smallest unit. Ini kita sebutnya konstituen. Nah, ketika kita analyze, when we analyze a sentence, we will separate all of those constituents into these rules. Is it important for us to know that? Well, honestly, if you only speak English, you don't need to know that. Sebenarnya kalau kita semua bahasa Inggris, kita nggak perlu kayak gini. But because our field is linguistics, so it's very important for us to know this. So when someone asks you, "Do you know about this?" You are credible. You are credible for your degree. Jadi dapat degree dan tahu apa yang dipelajari selama ini. So contohnya ini tadi, this is the example. John is a noun phrase. Noun phrase consists of noun, and sometimes, see, from the rule, noun phrase consists of determiner, noun, or prepositional phrase, and those in the bracket is optional. So John is a noun phrase, then noun. Because there is no determiner, we do not need to write this. And the boy, then a little boy, a little boy, determiner, adjective, and noun. And noun phrase again, a boy in the bubble. So, bisa dipahami nggak, Mbak, Mas? Kenapa ini bisa seperti ini?
Iya.
Atau masih bingung?
Bingung nggak, ini?
Bingung, Mas.
Saya pakai bahasa Indonesia dulu ya.
Harusnya di blackboard, whiteboard yang samis, biar terang semua.
Apa daya kalau ada nih cuma ini?
Itu di belakang itu bisa.
Oh itu bisa ya?
Bisa itu.
Emang bisa?
Bisa itu.
Susah. Tidak ngalir itu.
Oke, misalnya ya. Boy. Bubble. Pertama, kita analisis dulu. Ini ada kata a boy dan
itu sentence gitu.
Ya, ini sentence. Jadi, ini kan levelnya level sentence. Dalam sentence di sini ada dua kalau ini saya bagi ada dua phrase. A boy dan in a bubble.
Noun phrase dan phrase.
A boy sini disebutnya apa?
Noun phrase.
Noun phrase. Kenapa noun phrase?
Not a boy, noun-nya
apa ya? Karena di sini ada boy, kalau ini hanya boy sendiri kita bisa sebut noun.
Non.
Tapi karena
jadi
acuan kita adalah halaman 8.2. Ini adalah aturan yang harus kita hafal. Jadi ini acuannya, kemana-mana kita melanjutnya ke sini. Jadi sentence, setelah sentence, noun phrase, setelah noun phrase, verb phrase, prepositional phrase, dan adjective phrase. Jadi a boy itu noun phrase. In a bubble, karena ada in, itu kan preposition. Tapi karena ada yang mengikuti, maka jadi prepositional phrase. Nah, karena ini noun phrase, berarti kan ada gini, ini sentence terdiri dari noun phrase dan
preposition.
Oke, bagus. Kemudian noun phrase sendiri di situ aturannya apa? Halaman 8.2.
Determiner.
Ada determiner.
Noun.
Noun. Nah, sudahkah kita menemukan determiner?
Sudah.
Apa? Kemudian noun-nya?
Boy.
Nah, ini disebut konstituen. Konstituen adalah unit terkecil. Jadi kita bisa memasukkan unit-unit tadi kalau kita sudah menemukan kata paling kecil. Kemudian ini prepositional phrase. Kita buka 8.2. Prepositional phrase isinya apa?
Preposisi.
Preposition dan
noun phrase.
Noun phrase. Prepositionnya ada
in.
Ada in.
Konstituennya in.
Nah, non phrase, non phrase tadi terjadi apa? Balik lagi.
Determiner.
And then noun. Determinernya apa? Dan
bubble.
Oke. Seperti ini. Jadi ini namanya tree diagram. Sudah bisa diikuti? Oke, kita buat lagi kalimat ya. Misal. Coba bayang buat kalimat. Sebelum kita belajar subordination. Silakan kalimat. Terserah apapun.
Yuni.
Yuni.
Yuli dan Mo. Yuli. Belum Yuni ke Yuli.
I still.
I apple in the market. Okay. Thank you. Really? I buy apple in the market. Okay. Kalau kita break down.
Dari apa saja? Noun. That is sentence.
Ini kan Yuli. Kemudian buy apple
in the market.
The market. Berarti Yuli kan ini masuknya ke subjek dulu kan. Ini kan ada subjek. Kemudian ada buy, ada verb, ada buy, ada apple. Berarti
verb phrase
in the market. Maka tadi
prepositional phrase.
Kita buat pertama sentence. Subjek ini maksudnya apa?
Non-phrase
kan? Non-phrase, berarti nanti dibagi tiga. Subjek ada non-phrase. Kemudian dalam non-phrase sendiri apakah ada determiner?
No.
Enggak, berarti langsung noun. Berarti langsung dimasukkan you.
You.
Yuli.
Ini udah masuk satu konstituen. Kemudian verb phrase. Verb phrase terdiri dari apa?
Terdiri dari verb
dan
non-phrase.
Ada verb dan ada non-phrase. Nah, sudah bisa dimasukkan konstituennya?
Bisa.
Apa?
Verbnya bisa.
Buy.
Kemudian non-phrase-nya?
Able.
Ada noun. Ada determiner kan? Tapi kan determiner nggak ada. Jadi langsung noun. Able.
Langsung noun.
Ya. Kemudian prepositional phrase terdiri dari apa ini?
Preposisi.
Preposition dan?
Dan noun phrase.
Noun phrase. Preposition sudah bisa dimasukkan?
Sudah. In.
In. Noun phrase. Ada noun dan?
Determiner.
Determiner dan noun. Determinernya apa? Noun-nya?
Marker.
So far sudah bisa dipahami. Jadi aturan yang dibuat Chomsky ini harus diikutin semua. Jadi misal, oh ini kan tadi verb phrase terdiri dari verb dan noun phrase. Balik lagi ke noun phrase. Kemudian ini prepositional phrase itu preposition dan noun phrase. Balik lagi noun phrase tadi aturannya apa? Jadi ketika kita belajar phrase structure trees, kita akan membagi kalimat itu dalam unit paling kecil. Dan unit paling kecil tadi disebut apa?
Constituent.
Perfect. Selanjutnya.
Nah, ini selanjutnya tadi prepositional phrase. Nah, ini contohnya. Phrase structure tree dari prepositional phrase. Sebenarnya kalimatnya sederhana, tapi kita breakdown jadi paling kecil.
Contohnya ini. The cat on the mat in the house on the street. Jadi kita pecah-pecah dulu. Ini kan ada the cat, satu. On the mat in the house on the street. The cat ada determiner dan noun. The and cat. Terus kemudian prepositional phrase yang pertama apa? On the mat. Nah, on the mat setelah itu diikuti lagi prepositional phrase yang kedua. In the house. Dan diikuti lagi prepositional phrase yang ketiga. On the street. Jadi semakin panjang kalimat itu nanti semakin kompleks tris diagramnya. Contohnya ini. Kalau sang, if only one verb, you only write verb. Ate the cake. Ate the cake. It becomes verb phrase. Verb and the cake. Noun phrase. Noun and determiner and noun. Kemudian, ate the cake hungrily. Hungry is adverb. It modifies the verb. So verb, noun phrase, and adverb. Sang a song in the shower. Sang. Shower. Kenyang ya, Pak? Ya, harus ngantuk. Oh, atasnya ini ada lampu. Oke, terima kasih. Sang a song in the shower. Pertama apa dulu? Kan sentence. Kemudian, sang a song in the shower. Berarti ini apa? Sang a song? For phrase, kan ini ada sang. Sang a song for phrase. In the shower apa?
Prepositional phrase.
Prepositional phrase. Setuju ya? Berarti ini pertama for phrase, yang kedua prepositional phrase. Kemudian dalam verb phrase sendiri terdiri dari apa? Verb dan
non phrase.
Good. Sudah bisa dimasukkan verbnya?
Sudah.
Sang. Noun phrase terdiri dari apa tadi?
Determiner.
Good. Kan? Nah, apa? Dan
song.
Prepositional phrase terdiri dari?
Preposisi.
Dan?
Preposition.
Noun phrase. Preposition sudah bisa dimasukkan?
Sudah.
Oke, what?
In.
Noun phrase terdiri dari?
Determiner.
Noun.
Good. So?
The shower.
Lebih gampang kan kalau saya jelaskan langsung. Kalau online kan kadang di awang-awang gitu maksudnya apa. Nah, ini akan juga berlaku ketika
ada slowly. Kemudian dari slowly itu masuk di adverb.
Nah, sekarang, what is the difference between phrase and clause? Phrase is a group of words that acts in a sentence as a single part of speech. Itu phrase. Clause is a group of words that has a subject and predicate that is used as a part of a sentence. So, which one is bigger? Mana lebih besar?
Bigger,
clause, ya? Jadi, Tata ya, can you give example clause?
Give example.
You play.
Okay, you play because you play consists of subject and predicate. That's a clause. But clause is not a complete sentence.
You play.
For example, this one. The basic unit of an English grammar is a clause. An unlucky student almost lost a 17th century violin worth almost £200,000. Jadi kalau ini buat urutan, urutannya itu seperti ini. Word, phrase,
clause,
then
sentence.
Contohnya, tanya word apple. Phrase.
An apple.
An apple. Clause.
An apple down.
Bisa apa? Ada harus ada subject dan verb. Berarti apa?
Simbal.
Okay, simbal.
Simbal an apple. Ini udah sentence.
Nah, sentence bisa lebih full. Misal.
Simple and never done.
So in the market, atau kalau subordinate, simple and able, which are very expensive. Nah, which are very expensive, ini menjelaskan apa?
Menjelaskan apple.
Apple-nya. Nah, which are very expensive ini disebut subordination. Saya kasih contoh yang lain. Misalnya, di sini ada banyak mahasiswa. Kemudian saya ketemu teman saya, terus saya ngomong sama teman, I know the student. Terus kemudian teman saya tanya, which student? There are a lot of students in the class. Saya bilang, oh student yang pakai topi merah. Berarti yang pakai topi merah itu menjelaskan student. Bagaimana saya mau pakai bahasa Inggris?
Which red top?
Hat. Bagaimana cara ngomongnya?
Which are red?
I know.
Which are used?
The student. Bla 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 is wearing
red
hat. Kira-kira blank space ini diisi apa? Gak sama pakai yang. Mana students?
I know the student who's wearing.
Who? Ada yang bilang who, ada yang bilang who.
That juga bisa.
Ada bilang that.
That itu umum sih. Tapi who.
Okay, yang benar apa?
Who.
Ada, yang benar adalah who. Who is wearing red hat? Kenapa who?
Menjelaskan seorang.
Karena ini, karena dia mengartikan subject. Kalau dia replacing subject, pakainya who. Kalau dia menggantikan kata kepemilikan, pakainya whose. Kalau dia menggantikan objek, pakainya whom. Masih ingat pernah diajari ini kan? Jadi, who is wearing red hat? Ini subordination.
Kalau which tadi menjelaskan apa?
Yang which itu
something.
Yang juga semuanya artinya yang. Jadi ada who, ada
who's,
ada who, ada which, dan that. Nah, who itu untuk menggantikan subject, whom itu menggantikan object, whose itu possessive, which dan that itu untuk benda.
Alamat nggak ada.
Itu untuk exclamation.
Nah,
contohnya ini, kapan kita, jadi sebenarnya kapan menggunakan, kapan itu mengartikan subjek, kapan mengartikan objek. Saya kasih contoh ya, bisa aja ya biar gampang.
I meet Johnny. To the office on Monday. Kalimat ketiganya, his wife is a nurse. Kalimat keempatnya, my son knows him well. Nah, saya ingin mengkombinasikan kalimat satu dengan yang A, kalimat satu dengan B, kalimat satu dengan yang C. Bagaimana caranya? Kita buat dulu ya, yang satu A. I met Johnny, he goes to the office on Monday. Mana yang sama subjeknya?
Subjeknya yang sama.
Johnny dan
he.
Karena Johnny dan ini kan dua orang yang sama. Sebenarnya kan I met Johnny. Johnny goes to the office on Monday. Those two subjects are similar. I told one person. So because I'm going to remove this, so this position is subject. When I want to remove
object.
The position, he goes. Ini subject kan? Subject verb. Ketika ini mengartikan subjek, maka menggunakan who. Jadi, I met Johnny who goes to the office on Monday. Itu yang pertama. Sekarang yang keduanya adalah, I met Johnny. Johnny mana? His wife is a nurse. Mana yang sama? Johnny and he. Sekarang his ini refers to Johnny's wife. Karena ini kepemilikan, maka pakainya who's. Yeah, possessive. Berarti I met Johnny. Which Johnny? Whose wife? Whose wife is a nurse? Itu kalimat yang kedua. Nah sekarang yang ketiga, I met Johnny. Johnny yang mana? Itu yang teman dekatnya anakku. My son knows him well. Kamu yang sama. Johnny dan him kan bukan my son kan
bukan.
Karena my son ini orang yang berbeda jadi my son knows him itu refers to siapa Johnny. Aku tahu loh Johnny. Johnny yang mana itu loh yang teman deketnya anakku itu loh nah itu loh itu kan masih ke Johnny kan nah posisinya him ini sebagai apa
objek
kan ini kan subjek ini verb dan ini objek nah karena ini objek jadi pakainya whom. So, I met Johnny, whom my son knows
well.
Well.